Welcome. I'm Peggy. Thank you for letting us be a part of your day. And we have two very special people here. And I think you and I'll have a chance to learn quite a bit. And I'm so happy to have from the Better Business Bureau of the Upstate. Sounds very, very important. V. Daniel is here. And she is the president and the CEO. And next to her is Hope Evans. And Hope is the PR director. So you're, and I don't know, I love South Carolina. I love the part of the United States. We're so blessed. We have the mountains, we have the ocean, and wonderful, friendly people. And there's so much here to be grateful for. And I get excited about just being here. And I think we have more and more people realizing that all the time because the traffic is getting where have you noticed?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I appreciate your coming.
Well, thank you.
And I'm going to ask, what does the Better Business Bureau do?
Well, the Better Business Bureau, we're a nonprofit, private organization, and we help build marketplace trust between consumers and businesses.
Marketplace trust. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we handle, as you know, we handle dispute resolution between consumers and businesses and hope to have a good resolution for with both parties. So we offer mediation and arbitration and a lot of other things.
And I guess you get a lot of complaints.
We do. We get a lot of complaints. You know, we cover the whole upstate, so as you can imagine.
Yeah, more than just Greenville.
Right.
We do. 10 counties.
Yeah. 10 counties.
Yeah. And do you have anything to do? You want people to come here?
Oh, absolutely. We love when people move to the upstate. You know, we have such a beautiful upstate. You know, all the way, we cover all the way from Greenwood to Cherokee to Oconee. And so, you know, it's a, like you said earlier, it's a very friendly place. Mm-hmm. It's a very business friendly place. So we like when you know, more businesses are moving in and
we have more businesses coming all the time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Lots of commercial construction and a lot of residential construction going on, and which is really nice because, you know, as we had a lull in the housing market for a long time, and it's nice to see things coming back and activity going and new people moving in.
All right. What are some of the things, if a company is looking to locate, what are some of the important things that they look for?
To locate in their business here?
Yeah. If they're moving, or if they're thinking about relocating a business or starting a business, mm-hmm. and they're coming to this part of the United States.
I mean, I would think it would definitely be the workforce. I mean, they would definitely want to move their business here if there's a good, strong workforce here that they, you know, that they can actually bring jobs and people, they will find good people, quality people to fill those jobs. So, you know, I think they look for that. I think they look for, it depends on what the business is looking for, whether they're wanting to be, you know, closer to Greenville, which is more city, or would they, you know, want to be more, you know, in Spartanburg or, you know, Abbeville or Clemson. You know, I guess, you know, depending on land and what's available to them and what opportunity is for their expansion and being able to expand as they grow.
Well, as the Better Business Bureau, are you looking to entice people to get them interested in coming here, or what is your?
No, actually,
what do you do?
That's more. That's actually probably more the chamber. You know, economic development.
That,
you know, there's a big, huge.
Because you know, we all hear about the Better Business Bureau, mm-hmm. But I don't really know. What do you do?
I mean, that's what we do. We're here to build marketplace trust between consumers and businesses. So we're all free services. So if you have a complaint against a business, you can come to the Better Business Bureau and file the complaint, and we act as a mediator for you between you and the business. Yes. So, and then if, you know, we stay a neutral party, and if you still can't come to a resolution, we have trained arbitrators and trained mediators that work through the BBB, that they're actually not staff, they're actually, you know, trained mediators that come in and will work with the business and consumer to help find a resolution.
We also host local events, like we have a Shred Day, we have a Business of Integrity events coming up.
Yeah. All right, you have events that go on all year long? Or are they just certain times of the year?
There's certain times of the year. We have an AB orientation that we host too. So we have like some events.
Yeah, with our Shred Day, I mean, we also, as you know, we're going to talk a little bit later on scams. We also work with scam prevention, where we help people to try to figure out if they are being scammed and what, and we provide tips. We're very educational. We have a foundation that actually was scam prevention and identity theft. So I do a lot of presentations to seniors because seniors tend to be the larger group that actually get scams or actually get scammed or frauded. And then so we do presentations, education. We, like Hope was just mentioning, we do four Shred Days a year. So it's a free Shred Day. You come and you, to protect your identity, you definitely mm-hmm. want to shred your information that you no longer want to keep.
And this is true for not just businesses, but individuals.
Our consumers. We have mm-hmm. more consumers than we have businesses. Yes. And we also, sometimes we forget businesses are consumers because their employees are consumers.
But I'm kind of thinking of individuals as well.
Mm-hmm, right.
You know, you just toss things into the wastebasket and you don't think about it.
Right.
And there is your address, your phone number, mm-hmm. your name, everything
right.
that you've discarded.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody else comes along and...
takes your identity.
I guess they
mm-hmm.
take...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, take your identity. I mean, even through the IRS, there's a huge IRS scam that goes on, and it continues to go on where you go to file your taxes and somebody else has already filed your taxes. So somebody that has already got your Social Security number, your
somebody
birthday...
Somebody would like to say, oh, that would be great. I wish I had my taxes filed.
Yeah, well,
so,
it's
but you mean
not
they
if you're
really
planning
do?
On getting a lot of money back.
They really do mm-hmm. that?
They really mm-hmm. do that. Actually, yeah. the IRS, if you go on their site, they talk about it.
Mm-hmm. And they get away with it?
Well, I'm sure
that's amazing.
That, I'm sure that, mm-hmm. I'm not sure if they get, I'm sure that there's times that they catch people, but I'm sure there's times that they don't. They're not able to.
So they're looking for people that they would get a refund on their taxes.
Right. And so that they're basically filing your those taxes in your name. So they're basically taking your identity. And then basically, they'll get your rebate instead of you.
You must hear a lot of this kind of thing.
Or I should say rebate and mm-hmm. refund.
I mean, you must hear a lot about, how in the world can you take somebody else's identity?
Easy. I mean, because if you're not shredding, I mean, there's dumpster divers, there's people looking for the opportunity. You know, that's why they say don't carry your Social Security card in your wallet or your purse if it happens to lose it.
Oh my
then
goodness.
You could have the potential of being, you know.
So okay.
a victim of identity.
Back up a minute now. You're educating. I'm learning a lot here. You don't carry your Social Security card or anything in your wallet.
Right. That's a tip.
Nobody
basically,
ever
a Better
told
Business
me
Bureau
that.
Tip is not to mm-hmm. not to carry your Social Security card in your wallet or your purse.
Okay, what else should you not carry, if that somebody could any kind of identification?
Any kind of identification, you know, your Social Security, your birth date,
passport,
you know, information. I mean, you should keep that. Probably locked up safe safe at your house or in a secure post office box.
Credit card, you should be careful just in case nobody wants
your credit card?
Yeah, just in case if you lose your wallet, for instance,
yes.
and somebody takes it and they want to, you know, go on a shopping spree, you got to make sure that you cancel your credit card just in case because you don't want somebody to steal your identity.
So if you were to lose your handbag or your
mm-hmm.
wallet.
Your wallet. Mm-hmm.
You right away would, what should you do?
I mean, the first thing I would do is start, if you have credit card, like Hope said,
credit card.
Start canceling
mm-hmm.
your credit cards. Call your bank, because most likely you have a debit card.
Yeah.
Make sure you cancel your debit card. If you had your Social Security card in there, I would definitely call the Social Security Commission and let them know that you've lost your card. And, you know, to get a replacement or because you have the possibility of being a victim.
There are a lot of things that we just don't mm-hmm. think about,
mm-hmm.
you know? So now we're heading into the time of year, but wonderful. But there are also, I think, more and more scams this time of year than any other. Am I right about that?
Right. Well, there's, you know, I think scams are happening now. There's so many of them that, I mean, I think they happen all the time. I mean, it depends on what type of scam it is. We'll see some scamming going on because of the Christmas holidays.
That's what I meant.
Yes.
Yeah.
You'll see some, you'll see different types of scams.
Like, what do you hear? When people come to you with problems, what are some of the things that you hear most?
Around Christmas, we get a lot more online scams where people are talking about being online because they went online and to buy something from, you know, this website, and next thing you know, they're not getting their merchandise they ordered. And what they thought that they were buying something from, you know, a retail store while they were on the site, when they went to pay, it took them to another site because that site had been hacked, and they're paying somebody else. So, you know, a lot of our scams that we see are international, so it's hard to track who those fraudsters are.
Oh, that would be a problem for you,
right?
Wouldn't it?
Well, for me and for us, we're nonprofit. We have to work with the government agencies that can do something about it. We work with the local police department. We work with the FBI. We'll work with, the Secretary of State, Attorney General's Office, Department of Consumer Affairs, because we're not enforcement, but we can, when we see something going on, we do report it.
So you follow through by reporting it?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So what are some of the things that come to mind, as we said, that you want to warn people about?
Well, social media. I would probably go with social media. So normally when you're shopping, you know, you find all these coupons, for instance, Bed Bath & Beyond.
Yeah.
There's been previous scams with that where you see like 50% off and, you know, you click it and it's actually a scam because it takes you to a site with a virus. So in terms of that, you just have to be careful what you click on. And always make sure it's a secure site by HTTPS, S for secure.
Okay, so there are things that we can do to help ourselves.
Yes, right. Mm-hmm.
We're going to go to a quick break, so we'll be right back.